Hello, we've had some interesting questions come in, so let's get stuck in and do some of these quickfire rounds and just see if we can get some answers there. The good thing is if you have a question to ask, there's a good chance somebody else will want to know the answer to that too. So it's good to hear as many questions as possible, and I'll dig in and try and do as many as I can. I've got some written here, so let's get stuck in. Okay, so the first one is from Nikki Yates, and she's asking about, she's doing an assessment and she has to do a makeup, and of course everyone's in lockdown at the moment, so she has to do the makeup on herself. So she's doing a prosthetic piece which is stuck to the bottom lip. Could you give me some advice on how to apply it safely and what glue is the best to use in this area? Obviously the thing about lips, anything you're gluing to a lip, what you don't want to do is glue on the inside here where that's wet, because that's the mucous membrane. You can't actually stick anything on that. So you have two choices really with lips. Lips are an absolute pain, frankly, with regards to prosthetics, because they almost certainly will let you down, because people eat, they drink, they rest cigarettes on them, they kind of touch their face, they may, you know, do that or whatever. So, you know, you end up just licking your lips, you know what I mean? So people use their lips like all the time. And so a lot of punishment goes on with the lips, and there's always a lot of moisture, and you know, they're just, from a prosthetic point of view, they're just a nightmare. So the edges around lips are always very, very critical, and they can easily get damaged, and we try and, you know, do the best you can with it, but it's nice if they can shoot their close-ups, you know, earlier in the day and rather than the end of the day, but they almost always are at the end of the day. But basically what you want to do with a lip, you have kind of two choices. You either finish the lip inside the lip, so the appliance actually continues inside the lips. You might only glue as far as the edge of the lip here, the vermilion border, or just slightly past it. And then the appliance is made in such a way that it kind of hooks like that, so it sits on the lip. So it's only glued up to a certain point, but then the rest of the piece is just the right shape to sit over the lip. So it technically finishes in the mouth, but the gluing stops before that point. It's kind of gross, because when they eat lunch and stuff, stuff's going to get trapped under there, so you have to clean it out. But that's a really good option if someone's got a sort of shout, and you can see, obviously when the mouth is open, you know, you can see into the bottom lip in a way that you can't see into the top lip typically, especially if the head is tilted down. So because of that, if you've got something that's really, really critical, it might be possible, might be necessary that the piece actually finishes like a hook, like I said, actually goes inside the mouth. But it doesn't sound like you've done that, obviously, because of that's something that happens at the sculpting stage. So the other way of doing it is to actually finish the edge of the piece just before the lip, so it doesn't go onto the lip itself. But if it does go onto the lip, it obviously has to finish really, really feather thin. And you could stick it down with something like Prosaid. There's two groups of glues, really. You've got your sort of water-based acrylic-y adhesives like Prosaid, Beta Bond. Neil Gorton does one called Pro Key, which is very good. And they're very sort of white. They're white glues that dry clear, and they're very acrylic-y. They remain sticky once they're cured, except Prosaid No Tack. But all the acrylic-y glues dry clear and they remain tacky. Those are good because you can put them on, let them dry, and then put your piece over the top and apply that to the glue once it's dried. Or you can use something like a silicone adhesive like Telesis 5 or Telesis 8, or there's Snappy G, there's Silabond from EBA. They're all kind of silicone glues that are clear, and they vary in duration of how long they take to dry. Telesis make a really cool, they make 8, and they make 8F and I think 8S, and the 8S is a slower setting, a slow evaporating solvent. The 8F is one that's very, very fast. So if you're doing touch-ups on set, for example, you've got something that sets really quickly, that's good. If you want more working time, if you've got a larger piece, use the slower setting one. So you can use either of those kinds of glues and they should work. The trick, I think, for me personally, is to make sure that you work out where the edge of the piece is going to be and glue slightly beyond it, and then let it dry. It's very important you let it dry and then put your piece down onto the dried glue, because if you leave the glue wet and put the piece down onto wet glue, it just won't stick at all, because the glue needs to be dry really for it to stick. It sounds counterintuitive, it tends to work better and it will stick better because it's a pressure sensitive adhesive, so if you press down onto the piece it really kind of grips in, and over time it tends to grip a bit more. So I would do it that way. the question then often a lot of people will ask is, how do you safely then blend off your edge? There's a couple of ways you could do it. One is to just very carefully remove your flashing before you apply it, so you don't have any solvent to use on the lip. But sometimes you can actually just melt the edge away. The trick is to do it very, very subtly. Just use a very, very small brush and just separate the flashing from the cap plastic. A lot of people drench it with a bigger brush and they're just trying to basically dissolve away all of the cap plastic, and that's the wrong thing to do. You want to leave the cap plastic remaining, you just want to separate the flashing. So the silicone finishes and then there's a little bit of cap plastic and then it stops. If you melt away all the cap plastic, you'll hit the edge of the silicone, and then that will get progressively worse over the course of the day. So that would be how I would approach the lips. You've got to do it very carefully. It may take a bit of practice, and it's probably worth maybe casting up an extra couple of pieces for around the lip, because obviously if the lip piece, you know, gets ruined, you may need to swap it out and put a new piece on. But yeah, they're tricky, but they certainly can be done. But practice is definitely the key. And one thing I think is really good, especially with lip pieces, is if they do go horribly wrong and things go all gnarly, is to take pictures of the problem, because they're very good things to show to somebody else, so you can illustrate what the problem is, and then it'll help you drill down to exactly how to fix it later. So hopefully that will be of some use to you.